First of all, you should not receive the diksha from somebody whom you do not like. That is best avoided. The next thing is, when you are giving the diksha or the blessing, you must be fully aware that you have become an instrument of the divine in order to help mankind. So you should clearly understand that the divine is flowing through you because it wants to help mankind, and that you are serving mankind. So there are two things here. You must be very, very clear that the diksha is not something which you are doing, but you are only an instrument for the divine. And the second thing is that the divine is wanting to help mankind, and that you are helping the divine. Not that you are helping mankind, because who are you to help mankind? You must realize that you are helping the divine to help mankind. If you have that kind of an awareness, then your good karma grows. It grows very, very fast. That good karma you could make use of for solving financial problems, business problems, problems at the job, or for your awakening, or for improving your health. For any purpose, you can encash it. Like you, if you have money in the bank, you can buy whatever you want. Similarly, in your good karma account, if you have good karma, you can encash it for whatever you want. Whenever you are giving a diksha to someone, you are gaining good karma, lot of good karma, because he is being helped. But you must be aware, you are helping the divine to help him. If that awareness is there, then you get good karma. If awareness is not there, you do not get good karma. That's how you have to understand it.